In this example, this figure shows a capacitor of capacitance without dielectric C. With plate separation, we can see it is D and the plate area A. And these dielectric slabs of different material and sizes are filled in the capacitor as shown in figure. Here we can see there are three slabs of dielectric constant K, 2K and 3K which are filled in the manner we can see in the figure. We are required to find the final capacitance after insertion of these dielectrics. We already discussed in previous sections about the variation in capacitance due to insertion of dielectrics. The very first thing we can do is we can draw its equivalent situation, like this K and 2K dielectric systems will behave as two capacitors in series, and this group will act as a parallel combination with the capacitor of dielectric 3K. So you can see in this situation the equivalent circuit we can draw like this. There is a dielectric slab of dielectric constant K over here. Then another dielectric slab of dielectric constant 2K over here. And a slab of a single dielectric constant 3K is here, which is connected in parallel combination with the dielectrics K and 2K in series. If this is of capacitance C1, this is of C2 and this is of C3, we can easily find out the equivalent capacitance of this combination. And for the same, let us first calculate C1, C2 and C3. So here you can see the value of C1 we can write as K epsilon naught. The plate area of this can be written as A by 2 divided by the separation within the plates is also D by 2. Here you can see this is K epsilon naught A by D. And we are given that the overall capacitance of the system without dielectric is C. Then C can be written as epsilon naught A by D. So in this situation we can see the value of C1 as KC. Similarly, we calculate the value of C2. This will be 2K epsilon naught A by 2 upon D by 2. So in this situation here also this 2 cancel out. It will be 2K epsilon naught A by D. So this can be written as 2KC. Similarly, if we calculate the value of capacitance C3, this we can see it will be 3K epsilon naught. Plate area is A by 2, but the plate separation we can see it is D. So in this situation, on simplifying, we are getting this is 3 by 2 K epsilon naught A by D. So we can see the result, resulting capacitance for the capacitor C3 will be 3 by 2 KC. As we are having these capacitances, we can see the equivalent capacitance across the combination XY can be written as C3 in parallel combination with C1 and C2. So C3 in parallel combination with the C1 and series combination with C2. So the equivalent capacitance can be written as, for parallel combination we know that capacitances are added up, and in series the reciprocals are added up. So the equivalent capacitance will be C3 plus C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. You just need to substitute the values of C1, C2, C3 over here, and you can see the value of equivalent capacitance CXY we are getting as C3 is 3 by 2 KC. Plus, if you substitute the values of KC and 2KC over here, this will be KC multiplied by 2KC upon 3KC. It will be 2 by 3KC. So the resulting value we are getting is 13 by 6KC. That will be the answer to this problem. This is the capacitance of the capacitor which we are given with the situation shown in figure.